Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Wednesday, July 18. For those of you joining us now, we are live inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team here has been monitoring the systems aboard the station and supporting the day's activities of the Expedition 32 crew members. Leading the Orbit 2 team here in the Station Flight Control Room today is Flight Director Richard Jones, seen there standing at the console, and next to him is serving as CAPCOM, relaying all ground messages up to the crew, is Anna Fisher. Aboard the orbiting complex, Station Commander Gennady Padaka and Flight Engineers Joe Acaba and Sergey Revin, who are in their 10th week in space, now have the help of three new crew members, Flight Engineers Russian cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko, NASA astronaut Sunny Williams, and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide, who joined them aboard the International Space Station early yesterday morning. The newest crew members of Expedition 32, Malenchenko, Williams, and Hoshide, launched aboard the Soyuz TMA-05M from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan on Saturday night. They began their two-day chase on orbit to catch up to the International Space Station. The Soyuz is now docked to the Rosviat module of the space station, having docked at 11:51 p.m. late Monday night, with hatch opening early yesterday morning at 2:23 a.m. Central Time. Meanwhile, they're aboard the station to greet their new crew members, Commander Padaka, with the flight engineers Sergey Revin and Joe Acaba, launched to the orbiting complex aboard their Soyuz spacecraft as the Expedition 31 crew in May. They're a vehicle docked to the Poisk module, seen here in this view is the TMA-04M. 2 days after their launch on May 14, today they will complete their 66th consecutive day in space. The space station with its crew aboard and the newly arrived Soyuz TMA-05M docked is now flying at an altitude of about 249 statute miles. The orbiting facility crossed into an orbital sunrise over the North Pacific Ocean about a half hour ago as it passed across southern parts of Canada just north of the United States. It is now making a southeastern track just across the North Atlantic Ocean on the between the west coast of Africa and the east coast of Brazil. Prior to the Expedition 32 crew waking up, the ground used the automated transfer vehicle 3 thrusters to perform a nominal reboost of the station. The reboost placed the ISS in the correct orientation for the Accelerated 48 Progress single-day rendezvous. The reboost was done with a burn duration of 19 minutes and 25 seconds. This reboost raised the altitude of the station to about 249 statute miles. The Expedition 32 crew, that expanded from 3 crew members to now 6 crew members as of yesterday, kicked off their first full day as a full crew aboard the International Space Station with a daily planning conference. These daily planning conferences are held with ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review the day's activities. After a 14-hour rest period that put them back on the normal station operations clock, the crew members began work on a variety of science experiments. They also performed some maintenance to their home away from home and prepared for the arrival of the third Japanese cargo spacecraft that is slated to lift off Friday night. Launch time is scheduled to take place at 9:06 p.m. Commander Padaka spent some time this morning transferring wastewater to the Rodnik tank of the Progress for eventual disposal. He performed his exercise and also began some handover activities of the Russian segment with Revin and Malenchenko. New to the station, flight engineers Sunny Williams and Aki Hoshide also participated in some handover activities with flight engineer Joe Acaba. Williams, Hoshide, and Malenchenko started a familiarization with onboard exercise equipment and also reviewed their countermeasure exercise plans. Exercise for long-duration crew members is essential to maintain their health and mitigate the negative effects of microgravity on their bodies. The onboard gym is equipped with a treadmill, a stationary bicycle, and a strength trainer known as the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device that simulates weightlifting on Earth. The trio also spent more time with station adaptation and familiarization. Much of today's work is focused on the pending arrival of the new cargo ship that is slated to launch to the International Space Station Friday night. The Japanese H-2 Transfer Vehicle 3, or the Kunitori 3, is scheduled to launch from Tanegashima Space Center in Japan Friday night at 9:06 p.m. Flight engineers Joe Akaba, Sunny Williams, and Aki Hoshide participated in an HTV-3 timeline conference. This is to review the upcoming cargo ship's arrival. They then participated in some onboard training of the vehicle's rendezvous and approach. Aki and Joe Akaba are presently working on some of the training with the robotics training. Williams also had spent some time to begin work and review for science research. One of these investigations, known as In Space 3, looks at the changes of physical properties of colloids and fluids in response to their magnetic fields. The research has possible technological application and structure design here on Earth, structures such as bridges and buildings to better withstand earthquake forces. Williams also reviewed procedures of onboard research known as BASS, BASS, Burning and Suppression of Solids, that studies the characteristics of a wide variety of fuel samples in microgravity. These research results may aid in the design of fire detection and suppression systems in microgravity here on Earth. On the Russian side of the house, flight engineer Sergei Revin worked with several ongoing experiments, one of which is known as the BAR experiment. This experiment looks at methods and instruments for detecting the location of loss of pressure aboard the station. And also flight engineer Malenchenko spent some time transferring items that was brought up on the newly docked Soyuz TMA-05M vehicle. You're getting a live view inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the Orbit 2 team continues to monitor the systems and the crew activities aboard the International Space Station. Later today, the Expedition 32 crew will participate in a few recorded messages that will be downlinked for later use. The crew members will do some evening prep work before their evening meal and pre-sleep period. They also will participate in their final daily planning conference before bedtime. The crew is scheduled to go to sleep at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control, Houston.